Beautiful property of Snowy's there in Torrens Park. And Lou Toop and I will be there at 2:30 for the open and then the auction at 3 o'clock this Saturday. So if it's of interest, make sure you are there as well. Now, back live with my guest, CEO of the marina at Hindmarsh Island, Andrew Chapman, and we're going to answer a couple of emails before we finish the show. First up, Andrew from Adam Smith is asking specifically about Hindmarsh Island, of course. He's not particularly aware of the values there, and he's wondering if you could tell him a little bit about the land values, the house values and so forth, and what you might expect property values to do over the coming years.
Right, thanks Tim. Well, Adam, I guess the interesting thing here is the different products that are available. We have vacant land available, waterfront starting around the 150 mark, averaging mid-150s, going up to the 270s, depending on where you're looking, different aspects, different releases. Street front, around 90,000, so it's quite an affordable entry level.
Definitely.
for an allotment. Street front homes, average price at the moment's around 340. Waterfront homes, average price around the 470 mark. And the terrace homes, which are the 2 and 3 storey terrace style dwellings around the marina, commercial marina basin itself, are averaging around 466 at the moment. So there's quite a diversity of range for people to buy in at different levels at the marina Hindmarsh Island. To give you an idea, waterfront homes currently on the market, I believe, from 389,000 up to 1.95 million. And terrace homes currently 339,000 up to 595,000. So a good spread across there. Stage 8, Platinum Waters release, people can get in there with no time limit to build from 154.
Well, quite amazing, because you'd have to say, as they do, there's something for everyone there.
There's something for everyone, and certainly we're not making any more of it after we dig this lagoon.
Yep.
So we see the prices heading north fairly rapidly.
Yeah, outstanding. Now, a question that you may have for Mike.
I certainly do. I've got an email here from Kim, Tim, and she says, is it better to fully pay your mortgage on your property before renting it out, or is it a better option to have a small mortgage on it if you're thinking of buying another home to live in?
Okay. Well, I'm reading from that simply Kim is moving out of current home into new home and keeping the old one to rent. Definitely needs some accounting advice, because there are some significant tax advantages in obviously renting property, but in changing from principal place of residence to rental property, there are some disadvantages. So I would absolutely advise getting some accounting advice. If it was just simply a matter of buying an investment property, I always reckon that having some type of mortgage to offset some of your income tax with the costs of maintaining the property, the management and so forth, is well worth having, where you can either offset your income tax or indeed have a claim at the end of the financial year. So that would be my best advice for Kim.
Good advice.
Well, Andrew, look, thank you very much for coming in and spending the time with us today. Really appreciated catching up and some good detail on what's going on at the marina. So thanks very much.
Thanks, Tim.
Great. Now, before we go, we have a preview on the showdown for next week, the Showdown 2, which is the property versus shares debate, an exciting second coming, if you like, from the previous one. And we'll head out now and have a look at some of our hot properties.
Next week on Toop TV, Showdown 2, Property versus Shares. Earlier this year, the Shares team took home the ultimate prize as the Showdown 1 winners. Now brace yourself for Round 2. Get ready for the ultimate war of words as two teams battle it out live in the studio to debate what the better investment is. In the Shares corner, we have our reigning champions, Baker Young stockbrokers Mark Potter and Ryan Bamford. While on the property side, Reese's Greg Troughton and Emma Slape are hungry for revenge. In this contest, there's only one way to decide the winner, and that's with your vote. Make sure you're watching live so you can have your say. Live 1 p.m. next Wednesday. We'll be right back.
thanks for tuning in to today's show. And remember, if you've missed any part of it, you can always podcast. And mark in your diary for next Wednesday at 1 o'clock, Property versus Shares, showdown number 2. It's going to be a fast and furious show. You must see it, and I'll look forward to seeing you at 1 o'clock next Wednesday. Toop TV.